Okay. For those of you who don't 100% know what's going on up here, they it's like they know me or something. Like, all my favorite things are macaroni and cheese, okra, and Diet Mountain Dew. If you cut me, I pretty much believe Diet Mountain Dew. So. That's, oh my gosh. Okay, so I had all these big plans for how I wasn't going to cry tonight. But that all just got ruined? Okay. So, as you can see, okay, here, I already started trying to get to my first sentence, and I'm already starting. Okay. Oh, it's hard, okay. As you can see, we have a great group of eighth graders, and, we would give awards, and they served this really big purpose because the choir did not have the legacy and the institutional knowledge that it has right now. And so there were people that really kind of got choir and knew what to do, and then there were kids that were kind of struggling along, but you know, they were kind of trying to get it. And so having specific awards like "you are very good" and "you are very good" kind of made more sense because it gave the it really kind of gave the stamp of approval, like follow this person and do like what this person is doing. But the choir has grown so much in quality, you know, it's really too hard to just look at, you know, one kid and go, you're better than the others. And we really have to be a team. So we're just striving to all be good all the time. So what I'm doing is a work in progress. But so this is the first year where we're not saying like you individually are the best at this and you're the best at that. So what I set out to do, it was eye-opening for me, and I loved this exercise. So I've been working on a document where I talk about each child, and the document is far long, but it's like 9 pages long right now. So we can't read through that tonight. So I'm gonna be talking about them as a group. So firstly, I wanna say that every year at this time, I get kind of depressed because we have these kids that rise to this level and they're like, we lose them. Oh, okay. So then I always think like last year we had a great group of eighth graders and I thought, well, how will we ever do what we do without those kids? You guys know those were good kids. Okay. And so then I think, oh, okay. And then this year started and these kids rose to the occasion and now I feel the exact same way about them. Like, don't go, please don't go. So it's just incredibly hard to lose them. I want to talk about their, okay. So I just want to talk like as a group, some of the things that have risen to the top of my impression of them. One of the things is that I think in there's such an aesthetic, like a strong aesthetic mind frame in this group. I really feel like this group will produce a higher than average number of professional musicians or people who are at least very serious about music as a hobby, be it like a professional singer, actor, director, arts administrator, or performing arts teacher. I feel like in this group of people that we've got amongst us right now, we're gonna see a lot of people that have a lot to say and a lot to do in the arts, and they're gonna keep the arts going strong, and they're gonna be leaders. This is a group full of people willing to put in extra time, and I don't say that every year. That's definitely a characteristic of this group, that be it singing Valentine's or a pop show coming in, doing like the voluntary groups and things like that. And there's people in this group that I know I can just say, here, do this for me, please do this, and they're just very reliable about jumping in and helping and doing the extra, so I really appreciate that. On a daily basis, when I'm working with these kids, I'm interacting with some kid, and this, the thought goes through my mind, wow, that's a perfect kid. That's a perfect kid. Which, you know, parents, I know at home, you probably see the dirty socks lying around or whatever, but to me, there's so many of them that are just the perfect kid. So I love that. They are also really creative and silly and fun. I don't know how many of our fame kids we have in the audience. I see Sam, thank you. So for example, you know, this is a huge program. There's 240 kids in the program, and not every kid comes in at brunch or lunch, but a lot of the kids come in and they entertain me every day. Like secretly, I like to act like, you know, I'm like, clean up that. But secretly, I'm like, oh, so fun. You're so cute. And I love watching as they make up songs. They dance around the room. And they ask me to put on the CDs. And can we do both?
Yeah!
You know, but I have to kind of roll my eyes and act annoying. But I love it when they come play in the living room. And they're just super silly and fun. They're making up stuff all the time. Some of the band kids have an opera going. It's crazy. Okay. They're also very cohesive. Like, one of my goals over the years have been to, like, have Dynamics support Fame and Fame support Dynamics and see it for the one family that it is. And this is a year that we have an exceptional number of kids that have friends, like really strong friends in both groups. And so they seem to get it, you know, how to support each other. So we're very happy about that. They're also inclusive. You know, we work on this all the time. I gotta tell you, all of us fail at it, but we try. And so this group has been exceptional at reaching out and making sure someone has a group to be with or a friend to be with. So we're very proud of them for that. They're very overt about their care. Just to kind of talk about, like, over the last 3 years, they had an unusual number of adventures. They got to perform at the State Music Convention last year, CASMEC, and then they got to do ACBA. There are a lot of choir kids that would love to do either one of those, and they did both of them back to back, so that's a lot of work. Give them a hand for that. They perform very well every year, receiving unanimous superior ratings at every contest they've been to. I've been kind of talking to some of you about it, but it's been fun reminiscing. Like, do you remember going to Brentwood, like 4 hours away on the bus, and seeing little David play on your harp? And as your bottle started pulling up, pop. That's fine. Some of the things that judges have said about them, one of the judges we had looked at them last year and said, when you sing, I believe you, which is a really high compliment. And then also saying things like, when I look at your choir, I look across the choir and all of you are engaged in what you're doing, you're committed to what you're doing. So, congratulations, eighth graders, on all your accomplishments, and I wish you the best as you move forward. And I'm going to let you turn around so you can watch them sing, and then if you guys want to